Hi, AT from CNC at Home. Last time, we cleaned up our tiles by removing some bumps off the side and wiping clear any fingerprints or grease that we had on them. Then using light burn, I set up all the numbers and letters I wanted to etch on each one of the tiles. I have the zero points set and I've made sure that the tiles are squared with the laser. I want to make sure that this distance matches what I programmed for this burn. I'm going to move the camera so we can see this better. I'm going to quickly program the controller to move 432 millimeters to make sure I end up at the opposite corner. We fired the laser back up and we see that we're just a little bit off. This is kind of what we want. We're really close. It's less than 1 millimeter off. Let's run the laser back to zero. Okay, so we're zeroed. Everything looks good, so we can start the burn. I'm going to run a square frame to make sure that the cut is exactly where I want it. This cord is concerning me. I think it's going to get bound up in the back corner. It could potentially catch a tile. Okay, that looked good. It was a little scary, so I'm going to need to figure something out for this cable. Here's my temporary solution. I tied the string to the cable, and I hung a carriage bolt on the other end. It's not a very heavy bolt, but it's enough to hold the cable up, and not too much to pull anything out of alignment. This seems to keep the cable up out of the way. I'll do a little test to make sure that it's working and not catching on anything. I used a feature in Lightburn called Floodfill. It's intended to help optimize the tool path. In this particular burn, because of how things are laid out, it did help a little bit with the timing. Unfortunately, it ended up introducing some errors into the numbers and letters. To correct this, I turned Floodfill off and ended up reburning all of this on top of what I had already burned. That helped fill in some of those little gaps and errors that creeped into the burn. Now that the burn is complete, we can see some of the unintended side effects from the Floodfill. After turning the Floodfill off, I reran the program so that it would go over everything again. This did a very good job of hiding some of the anomalies that crept into the burn. After the reburn, we can see how well it cleaned up with Floodfill off. In the next video, we'll cover how to clean the paint off the tiles and get them all nice and shiny again.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.